Do you have enough self-confidence in your life? Would you benefit from an extra dose of confidence? Give me a few minutes of your time so I share with you how I boost my confidence and how you can too. Hello, my name is Kamran Akbarzadeh, founder of Dream Achievers Academy and author of award-winning books Leadership Soup and Get What You Want. Thank you so much for watching this video on personal excellence. One of the major obstacles that prevents many of us from achieving great things in our lives is our lack of self-confidence. When we face challenging situations or have to do unfamiliar tasks, we tend to lose our confidence because of associated risks, because of the doubts that we have, and also because of our fears. Lack of confidence results in procrastination and delaying what is necessary to be done. Those who suffer from lack of confidence cannot make decisions easily and they hesitate to take the lead. But let me tell you something. This is normal. Our brain has been wired this way. Even those who look very confident face similar challenges. When they have unfamiliar tasks to do, when they have something new to do, when they have to get out of their comfort zones, their confidence level is also challenged. So this is normal and this is for everyone. But the difference is that some overcome their challenge, some overcome their fears and doubts and take action anyway, while many do nothing and wait. That's the major difference. Those who overcome their doubt and fear and take the action anyway are typically the ones who succeed in life. They are the ones who are highly successful. They are the ones who are high achievers. Now, gaining confidence or boosting your confidence level does not need to be hard. It can be done rather quickly if you know what to do. So let me tell you how I boost my confidence, how I gain confidence when I face challenging situations or when I have to do challenging tasks. So here's the first thing that I do when I face a challenging situation or task that challenges my self-confidence and I need to boost my confidence or gain confidence. I ask a question from myself. And here is the question. Can you imagine a positive outcome? Yes, that's the question you ask yourself. Can you imagine a positive outcome? For instance, can you imagine a positive outcome if you end this relationship? Can you imagine a positive outcome if you start this relationship? Can you imagine a positive outcome if you quit your job? Can you imagine a positive outcome if you start your own business? Can you imagine a positive outcome if you invest in this new venture? Can you imagine a positive outcome if you take this risky task? That's the question you have to ask yourself. That's the first question you ask. Can you imagine a positive outcome if you take this thing, if you face this challenge, if you do this risky task? So that's the first thing that I do. I ask this question of, can you imagine a positive outcome? Then the second part is another question. And this question is, do you believe in this positive outcome? Do you believe in this positive outcome? So the first one, you imagine it in your mind, in your head, a positive outcome. If you can imagine a positive outcome, then you ask yourself, do you believe in this positive outcome? For the answer to the second question, I refer to my heart rather than my head or mind, because my heart tells the truth. The heart is linked to the soul. No matter how challenging the situation is, if you refer to your heart, you know internally that that's the right path to take. Now, if I get a yes to the second question, I go for it. I take the leap of faith and take the first step, because that first step can open some gates that were closed before taking that first action step. If I get a solid no on the other hand, I don't go for it. If my heart does not believe in an ultimate positive outcome, then I have enough confidence to say no and stick with my decision. Now, if it's a maybe, if it's not a yes, not a no, but a maybe, I still have doubt and need to clarify with myself the positive outcome. Focusing on an ultimate positive outcome can boost your self-confidence. On the other hand, referring to your heart and believing in that positive outcome can remove your doubts and urge you to take the necessary action steps. So you got the process that I use. What do you want to do now? Do you have enough confidence to try it out? I encourage you to test it out for yourself and see the results. Here is your task. Consider something that is important to you to accomplish or figure out, but you don't have enough confidence to move forward. So take yourself through the process that I shared with you. Ask those questions from yourself. The first question, can you imagine a positive outcome? And the second question that you ask from your heart, do you believe in this positive outcome? And if your answer to both of these questions is yes, then I'm sure that your confidence level rises automatically and you gain enough confidence to take the first step and move forward. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you did, I appreciate if you click the like button and also share it with others. If you have not subscribed to my channel, I appreciate if you do so right now. Thank you very much again. Until next time, live the life of your dreams and make a difference consistently.